Welcome back. Surviving this pandemic is not easy. Being pregnant adds another layer of concern. COVID-19 infections in expecting mothers have led to an increase in stillbirths and depression. With us now to talk more about this is Dr. Kecia Gaither, a New York OB-GYN. Good morning, doctor. How are we this morning?
Good morning. How are you? Good to be here.
Thanks for being with us. And I was just telling you in the commercial break that I myself just returned from maternity leave. This is day two for me. I had a pretty easy pregnancy, but for a lot of women, it is not easy living this pandemic and being pregnant. I was constantly paranoid. Is there a reason for that paranoia?
Well, certainly in the beginning of the pandemic, yes, there was reason to be paranoid and to have fear and trepidation and all those things. Certainly we have kind of moved past that to a more normal as one can be in this situation with prenatal care.
There does seem to be an increase in complications, though, after perhaps a woman who's pregnant did have a COVID-19 infection. Can you talk about those complications?
Oh, most definitely. COVID is a nasty player, and it affects multi-systems throughout the body. So there can be dermatologic issues, there can be eye issues, cardiac issues, certainly transmission to the baby. Fortunately, there has not been that many to my knowledge, at least in my system. But one thing that I am seeing a lot of is that babies are having in utero fluid around their hearts. That's called pericardial effusions, which I think is definitely a symptom of COVID infection being transmitted in utero.
And you say you have three ways to help improve pregnancy outcomes. Can you talk about those?
Absolutely. Certainly one of the most important things is hand washing, social distancing, mask wearing, and ensuring that you're seeing your physician. The second thing is there's been a lot of data that has come out concerning vitamin D supplementation as far as mediating or helping to decrease the incidence of complications from COVID. Vitamin D is inexpensive. Certainly, you can get it across the counter. One would need to have a level of 40 to 60 nanograms per milliliter. It's important that you have your provider check your levels. If you don't have that option, there's a wonderful website called powerofd.org, which is a great site for not only getting a test kit, but also for seeing other information concerning vitamin supplementations outside of vitamin D. For women of color, I think it's very important to know about your vitamin D levels. Vitamin D is made in the skin. It's inhibited by melanin. It's made in conjunction with sunlight. And certainly since we're all in-house now, we're not getting a lot of sunlight. So for women of color, it's very important to have this vitamin D level on board.
What a great tip.
The other thing I want to mention, vitamin D not only has helpful actions with COVID, but also for bone development, fermentation, and for preventing preterm labor.
Gotcha. Okay. Well, for more information, you can visit KeciaGaither.com. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. We really appreciate it, doctor.
You're right.